you ever tried typing on lined paper, ruled paper? I tried it years ago and soon discovered that starting at the top of the page with my text carefully centered between the lines as I typed down the page, my text would soon drift out of phase with the rulings on the paper to where I was soon typing on the lines and it was very illegible. So I dropped the idea of using ruled paper, and for years, maybe the only time I would ever use ruled paper with a typewriter is I would fold the paper in half and then insert it in the typewriter so the rulings are now vertical, and I would type crosswise to the lines. And that's worked pretty well as a way of using a notebook or filler paper or legal pad paper as typing paper. I've kind of liked that. But more recently, I've kind of gotten interested in the idea of exploring typewriter line spacing and the different kinds of ruled papers that you can find here in the United States, and searching for a type of ruled paper that's compatible with typewriter line spacing. And I've made a few personal discoveries that has opened up a new way for me to use ruled paper with typewriters, and I'd like to share that with you today. Stay tuned. It is kind of an interesting question as to why a person would type on lined paper to begin with. Lined paper is best suited to handwriting because it gives you a ruling with which to keep your writing straight and even, whereas mechanical typewriters, by their nature, create straight lines of text if they're working properly mechanically. But I've been interested for a long time in this idea of typing on ruled paper, even though books and magazines and printed material that you see created commercially on printing presses isn't printed with lines between the text. But still, it kind of interests me. So perhaps one of the reasons why you might choose to type on ruled paper is for a particular graphic style to your work that sets it apart differently from the average typewritten page. It doesn't look like commercially printed text, because very few commercially printed pieces are printed on lined paper, ruled paper. On the other hand, maybe it's a particular style you're after, just a unique look. Does the rulings make the text more readable, perhaps? Well, that's a good question, because very few people type on ruled paper in such a manner that the typewritten lines stay even with the rulings, so most people haven't really seen that. In my brief little exploration of typewriter line spacing and ruled paper as sold in the United States, I've noted that, first of all, most mechanical typewriters have a line spacing, a vertical line spacing of 6 lines per inch, and that's in the single spaced mode. Now, you'll see typewriters, a few of the typewriters made in the United States in the Depression era prior to World War II might have only had single line spacing and not any other option, but most typewriters have at least single and double, or sometimes single, double, triple, and often European typewriters will have single, 1.5, and double line spacing as an option. But in the United States, there are common standards for ruled paper, and I say standards loosely in brackets here because you'll discover here that not all of them are consistently the same. But first of all, there's narrow ruling. A narrow ruling is 1/4 inch or 4 lines per inch, and this is commonly found in grid papers, quadrille paper, but I've seen it more recently now used in composition books. But it is a narrow ruling, a little too narrow for my purposes, even for handwriting. And then next is what's called college ruling. And college ruling is nominally 9/32 of an inch spacing between the lines. But this spacing does vary by brand, and it is inconsistent. There are some inconsistencies between brands that we'll look at. Next is wide ruling. And wide ruling is 11 32nds of an inch nominally. Also, this varies slightly by brand. It's not as precise as you might think it would be. So there is some inconsistencies there. And then there is Gregg ruling. Gregg ruling is supposed to be exactly 3 lines per inch, and it's supposed to have a vertical ruling down the middle of the page so that people doing shorthand can use two short columns to do their shorthand in. There's an alternative to Gregg ruling, an alternative type of shorthand ruling that is 1/2 spacing or 2 lines per inch. What's interesting about all of these different rulings is that if you take the typewriter line spacing standard of 6 lines per inch, and if you set your typewriter to double spaced mode, you will be typing 3 lines per inch, which happens to match, yes, Gregg ruling. Gregg ruling, stenographers' books, are ruled at 3 lines per inch, and that is compatible with typewriters set to double line spacing, which I found to be quite interesting. Now, I found, as I was exploring this whole idea of ruled paper and the various formats of rulings found here in the United States, I found some internet references to line spacings that were plainly wrong. For instance, several places mention that Gregg ruling is the same as wide ruling, and that is not true. Wide ruling is nominally 11 32nds. And then if you take 3 of those, if it did equate to Gregg ruling, 3 of those would fit to an inch. But 3 times 11 32nds is 33 32nds, which is an inch plus that little 32nds of an inch extra. Does that little extra make a difference? Well, starting off at the top of your page, it may not, but you'll soon find even a quarter of the way down your page, you're already typing on the line, on the ruling between lines, because that extra 32nd of an inch adds up. Every little line, it adds up. So it has to be precisely 3 lines per inch. So Gregg ruling, if you think of it in terms of how many 32nds of an inch is Gregg ruling, keeping in mind college ruling is 9 32nds, wide ruling is 11. Well, Gregg ruling is actually 10.66666 32nds. So it's slightly less than 11 32nds, right? I started looking at composition books. I started looking at lined papers, ruled pads of papers in my assortment of used papers that I have around my office. And I'd like to show you some of the inconsistencies between brands of papers that claim to be college ruled or wide ruled. We'll look at Gregg ruling. We'll look at some legacy papers that appear to be Gregg ruled, but they're regular filler paper. And look at some of the ways I use Gregg ruling and another alternative.
This is Gregg ruling. This is one of these light green notebooks, 6 by 9 inches, spiral bound. You have to tear the pages out to remove them. I'm just going to show you the rulings here. We'll start at the top on this line right here, at the 1 inch mark, exactly on a line, the 2 inch mark, the 3 inch, the 4 inch, etc., all the way down the page. It maintains an exact ruling of 3 lines per inch, which is equivalent to double spacing on a typewriter. So this here is Staples brand in the wide ruling. And if I turn it sideways, what I find is I get 19 lines into 6.5 inches. So you'll see if I start over here on the left side, I can go exactly to the 6.5 inch mark before I get another ruling that exactly lines up. So that's 19 lines in 6.5 inches, which amounts to 10.95 32nds. So this is a 0.05 32nd less than 11 32nds, but it's not wide enough to be Gregg ruled. So again, a measurable difference, right, between the two. Now here's an example of a miscellaneous legal pad that is not wide ruled or Greg ruled exactly or college ruled. It is old and yellowed, and I don't know how old it is. There's no brand name on it. But as I measure it, starting at the top ruling here, I have to go all the way out to 8.5 inches before the rulings exactly line up again, which amounts to 27 lines into 8.5 inches, which is 10/32 instead of 11/32. So this is smaller than both wide ruled and Greg ruled. So again, there's inconsistencies in the manufacturing of these papers between brands. Now, when it comes to college ruled paper, some of it was made pretty accurately. Like this right here, I think just from the color of the ink, this might be a Staples brand sheet of paper from a college ruled pad. And it goes 16 lines into 4.5 inches. The 4.5 inch mark is here where they line up here, if I start over here. And that amounts to exactly 9/32 of an inch. So some of these are pretty close to what they should be. So this is 9/32. However, on the other hand, there is this Mead supposedly college ruled notebook from a few decades ago, that measures in at 7 lines every 2 inches, which amounts to 9.1432. So this is a little bit larger than the standard 9/32 that it should be exactly to be college ruled. In the meantime, here is a marble-covered composition book that's supposed to be college ruled, and it measures in at 12 lines every 3.5 inches, which is 9.3332. So a little bit wider than the Mead college ruled, but not exactly 9/32. So here's another Mead college ruled 3-subject notebook. And this one, just like the other Mead notebook, it also measures in at 7 lines every 2 inches, which is, again, 9.1432, a little bit larger than the standard of what it should be. Well, on the other hand, here are 2 legacy pads of paper I got from thrift stores. I don't have any branding on them at all, but they're both, even though they're letter size 8.5 by 11, they're both exactly 3 lines per inch. Isn't that cool? 3 lines per inch, and it maintains that spacing across the entire length of the paper on both of them. So here's an example of, at some time in the past, somebody made regular letter size paper in Greg ruling that would be perfect for typewriter use. Except they don't make it anymore, apparently.
When I started exploring this whole thing of line spacings and typewriters and ruled paper, I went searching around in my bins and stacks and piles of paper here in the office, and I did come up with this old EXP brand of steno book. And just like a lot of other Greg ruled steno books, I find them to be in either 5 by 8 inches or 6 by 9 inches. And I went on a lengthy internet search looking for letter size, 8.5 by 11, letter sized paper in Greg ruling. And it's almost impossible to find. I say almost because I did find an example of a paper bound book of Greg ruled paper in 8.5 by 11. But it's bound, so that means if you wanted to use each individual page in a typewriter, you'd have to literally take a razor knife and slice out each page. It just seemed like uneconomical. So the problem with Greg ruling is that you can't really find full letter size paper. So you're stuck with smaller paper. And you also have the issue of, in order to make it typewriter compatible, it's easiest to use it in the double spacing mode on your typewriter. So 1 line nicely positioned between 2 of the rulings. But that means double spacing, narrow paper, that means you don't really get that many words on a piece of paper, right? So if you're contributing, for instance, to the one typed page blog, you'll probably have to write 2 pages to get 1 page's worth, 1 letter-sized page's worth of text. So that is a problem, and I do have a potential solution for that as well.
This is an example of one of my private typewritten journal articles that I typed on this Greg Rule paper. I give it a rather short margin, maybe 3/8 of an inch, a little over 1/4 of an inch. I put a title up on top. I do a little bit of indentation for the paragraph and, of course, double spaced. When I set up the paper in the machine, I try to set the baseline of the typing text just above the bottom ruling so that instead of it being centered halfway up between the lines, I'm making it a little closer to the bottom, and it looks a little better. I like it that way. Also, it does give me room to space up one line and type insertions if I need to do that, especially with this 11 character per inch Olympia Splendid 33 typeface. But I like the way this looks.
I'm going to probably be using some of this steno paper for a while. In fact, this legacy pad of steno paper is the light green color, which I kind of like the color of. I more recently, just the other day, I went to my neighborhood big box office supply retailer and bought another steno pad of white Greg Rule paper, but it's not perforated. So I ordered a steno book of the light green in perforated form, because without the perforations, you have to deal with the little chads, and you have to trim that off to make it look neat after you typed on it. But the thing about Greg Ruling and using typewriters is you have to double space, right, to make it practical. I have experimented with trying to single space and trying to fit two single space lines between the Greg Ruling, and technically it'll fit provided you have a smaller typeface that's not so tall vertically. And even so, though, you have to be very careful about how you space vertically, how you start the paper so that the bottom and the top are equally centered between the lines. And then if you have a little bit of misalignment horizontally or in a tilt fashion, you'll see the lines very easily. You can see that kind of tilt off and start to hit the ruling. So I prefer to use the double spacing just because it makes it a little bit easier and more readable. But I haven't really been a double spacing person with typewriters. I think 1.5 spacing is my preferred spacing. But there are advantages to double spacing in the sense that it's easy to do insertions and corrections of text. In fact, these very notes right here, I've done a series of insertions.
This is what I thought was very cool, is striking out an error like in the word adjustment and then retyping a half a line above it, the correct letters. It works really well. Further down the page, you might be able to see here that I like to do additions to insert above the line typed corrections, like I wrote here, and for stream of consciousness writing where some immediate edits may be necessary in parentheses above it, or for inserting additional marginal thoughts. I thought that's a really cool thing you can do by double spacing on a half-spaced machine with a small typeface. You can go a half line above it and add these nice little marginal thoughts.
I kind of like that, actually. It makes it almost like you have a second voice, like your inner editor can afterwards go back and type these parenthetical thoughts in the space between the lines. I kind of like that. It's kind of cool. But yeah, it does take some getting used to, and you don't get as much text on a paper. That is one problem with double spacing on Greg ruled paper in this 6x9 inch size.
Here's an example of how difficult it can be if you want to type single-spaced and get both lines between the Greg ruling. Here is an example where I initially tried it. I set the bottom line down here, but it was a little too high, so now the top line runs into the next ruling above it. And here I made an adjustment to it, so they're both centered now. But you can see the paper was a little bit crooked in the machine. So because you're so close to the upper and lower ruling, any misalignment, you'll see the line get crooked really easy. So I don't really recommend single spacing on the Greg ruling. I think the double spacing looks a lot better.
Now, I did discover one interesting thing about Greg Ruling, which is, of course, it has the vertical red line down the middle of the page, front and back. And I discovered when I was threading it in my typewriter, you know how you thread the paper in and then you want to get the paper precisely aligned? Well, I discovered that I can line up the red line between the front and the back side. So when the red lines line up, the paper's lined up. And the other thing is, if you happen to want to write personal letters on lined 6x9 paper, these fit in the smaller size envelopes, right? So that means that for small typewriters that are too short of a carriage for a number 10 envelope, you can address your letters in your typewriter as well, because you're using smaller paper for smaller envelopes. So one thing I would like to recommend to you, if you do want to try using Greg ruled paper and double line spacing on a typewriter, is to use a typewriter that has the half line feature. Often these are European brand typewriters. So the line spacing selector in your typewriter would be 1, 1.5, and 2 instead of 1, 2, and 3. And the way you can tell whether your typewriter is a half line spacing typewriter is if you set it to this single line spacing position, when you move the carriage or turn lever, if you feel 2 clicks of the ratchet gear, that means it's a half line spaced typewriter. Using a half line spacing typewriter means you can click up one half line and type right above your ruling to do corrections, insertions, stream of consciousness commentary to your own writings, maybe in red ink instead of black. I've done a little bit of that on my notes here for this video, and I like the way it looks, but you have to have a half line spacing typewriter for that to work. And also, obviously, for 6x9 paper, it helps to have a smaller typeface, either 11 or 12 or smaller characters per inch.
Well, coincidental with my interest in line spacing and typewriter usage, my friend Ethan was interested in making a device, like a template, to line sketch paper with pencil specifically, so he could use the pencil lines as a guide for his handwriting, and then he could later erase the pencil lines. And so since he made himself a grid or a template out of laser cut acrylic, I had him make one in Greg ruling that is sized for letter size paper. And then you can take your little pen or mechanical pencil or whatever and make rulings on either side, and that will be nominally Greg ruled. I did find that it's difficult to do this well with a fat ballpoint pen. You really need to do it with more like a really fine mechanical pencil or a super fine ballpoint pen, a really fine nib. For instance, these graphic arts pens, this is 0.3 millimeter markers, and that works fairly well also. But this one here I did in the 0.3 millimeter mechanical pencil lead using the template, and I was able to achieve a really nice ruling in pencil. And then I put the machine in my Underwood typewriter with the red ribbon, the red side of the ribbon, and I typed line numbers on the left side so that every line is numbered like the way legal documents or legislative bills are written, like this, with each line numbered. I thought it was kind of a fun little effect, and that's something you can play with if you make your own Greg ruling template or stencil for making your own lined paper.
However, if you are going to go to the trouble of creating your own template to hand line Greg rule paper in larger size pages, like letter size, for instance, then you could also consider making word processor generated ruled paper. Make a template in your favorite word processor, or the word processor you hate to use but you have to use anyway, which shall go nameless. Anyways, you could create your own lined templates and print them out on laser printer on your favorite paper. And that's a great option. I think it's actually better than hand scribing, considering, you know, if you want penciled in lines, you can certainly only really can do it, practically speaking, by hand with a mechanical pencil. But if you just want faint, nicely printed, not too obtrusive rulings, you really want to use something like a laser printer, right? That's a great option as well. And also, if you're going to go to the trouble of creating your own ruled paper, you could also do paper ruled for 1.5 line spacing, which is 4.5 lines an inch or 9 lines every 2 inch. And that would match the 1.5 line spacing of your typewriter, which I don't think anybody has ever made that specific ruling in commercially made papers. Well, for me personally, I'll probably stick with using Greg-lined stenography tablets as my source of lined paper for use with typewriters rather than printing my own custom templates. It just seems a lot less troublesome. The paper is already available in a variety of colors, etc. But it does present one little issue for me personally, and that is the way I archive my writings, my typing specifically, usually it's going to be on letter-sized paper. I three-hole punch it. I put it in a three-ring binder. That works great. The problem with 6x9-inch paper, however, is it really is too short to three-hole punch in a regular three-hole punch configuration. So what I did last night is I have plenty of this 32-pound paper. It's actually a little too thick or too stiff for use in a lot of my typewriters. But I went and cut down a bunch of paper into vertical strips that are 2 1/8 inch across. So I get 4 of these out of a 8.5 wide sheet of paper. And then I three hole punched them, right? So now I have a whole supply of these thicker little strips, and all I have to do is tape the two corners in the middle of one edge, tape a sheet to this strip, and now I can file these in my three ring binder. And it doesn't present itself as much of a waste of paper as it would be by taping this sheet to another letter-sized sheet of paper. This is a lot less wasteful, and I like that solution. Well, the other day I was over at my neighborhood big box office supply retailer looking at stenography tablets and measuring lined paper. And the way you do that, by the way, is you walk over, first of all, to the drafting supply section, and you grab one of the straight edges off the shelf, and then with their straight edge, you go over to the line papers and you measure them and you do your little study. Oh, this is not exactly 11/32 or 9/32. I'm also humored by the thought that perhaps if a few of you guys out there discover you like to use Greg ruled line paper to type on, or maybe you're curious and you'd like to try it, somebody in some regional warehouse or distribution center is going to start noticing, you know, we have this run on Greg ruled stenography tablets lately. I wonder what that's all about. Well, I hope this enables you to be a more creative writer. It certainly helps me, as I like the various format differences that lined paper offers over conventional unlined paper. It sets this rigid standard already there for me to type into. And it makes it feel different. The writing process is different. It isn't for everything. And I may not always use it, certainly, but it is one option in my arsenal of creative tools. And I wish you the best in your creative journey as well. Stay well. Have yourselves a great day. Bye-bye for now.